Frederick again here at the What's What Studios. Today we are going to talk about climate change, energy consumption, and all the factors that fall between, to define two key points: energy consumption's effect on the climate and the changing climate's effect on energy consumption. But all the paradoxes, their complex effects on each other, the pros, the cons, where to begin? All right, calm down, Frederick. Help is coming. We can do this. Establish problems, brainstorm innovative ideas, understand new policies, contribute. Okay, we're okay. But before we go green, environmentally lean, and fight the climate changing machine, don't forget to subscribe below. Climate change, in the most basic sense, is a change in global or regional weather conditions over a long period of time. A lot of factors contribute to global climate change. Some are natural, such as volcanic eruptions, which, believe it or not, can block a percentage of solar energy from reaching the Earth. The Earth climate has always been ever-changing, but nowadays it's different. Us humans are causing climate change at a higher level and faster rate than ever before. When the cause of climate change is human, we refer to it as anthropogenic climate change. In particular, the burning of fossil fuels releases enormous amounts of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, and these gases trap sunlight and heat up our planet. But humans are not the only animals who have an effect. Cows contribute to climate change too, emitting between 70 and 120 kilograms of methane every year, which is 28 times more impactful on the climate than carbon dioxide. Let's not put the burden on the cows. The energy supply sector, comprising of energy extraction, conversion, storage, transmission, and distribution processes that deliver energy to the end user, is the largest contributor to global greenhouse gas emissions. If we continue at the rate we are going, global temperatures will increase. We'll be exposed to more seasons of extreme weather: heavy rains, drought, mega fires, storms. See a decrease in ice, snow, and permafrost. Monsoons will become larger and occur more frequently. Oceans and lands will lose their ability to absorb carbon. The scariest part: many of these changes will be irreversible. Imagine a world without snow, the constant threat of disaster. It would be a scary future. And some of these changes are already in sway. Even today, climate change has made a drastic effect on how we consume energy. Believe it or not, climate change is one of the main reasons for failure in our power systems. To discuss this topic in depth, I met with my good friend Sophie, a sustainable development manager from Nexans. She's something like a wizard of sustainability. Hey, Sophie, what have you got for me?
Let's start with one circumstance. When temperature rise, the demand for electricity increase because of a greater need for space cooling.
So increasing demand on the grid is simply due to the rising global temperature?
Not quite. As you mentioned earlier, climate change makes our weather pattern more extreme. So it's not just the heat that has its effect. In Texas, millions of customers lost power after several plants shut down due to below freezing temperature. The choice was either to cut power or risk collapse of the entire grid.
But why the equipment couldn't be maintained?
Consider, parts of our supply networks were built more than a century ago. 70% of the grid's transmission line were installed over a quarter century ago. And the average power plant is around 30 years old. These networks were designed to meet demands based on the climate condition of the time. With the recent shifts in weather, networks are facing new risks they simply weren't built for.
We need newer, smarter equipment.
modification at the very least. On one hand, we need energy to battle against global warming. On the other, energy consumption and usage is a huge contributor to climate change. This paradox exists in many technical solutions too. Take electric cars, for example. They release less fuels into the atmosphere, but at the same time, their charging needs increase demands for electricity, and in turn, put additional stress on the grid.
So stress on the grid is multiplying from all angles.
Right. But fortunately, legislators and industry pioneers are pushing for the production of renewable energy and smarter grid systems.
Okay. So what else can we do to help as individuals?
There are millions of ways to reduce our daily impact, and most of it is easier than we think. For what, Frederick? We can cut waste by drinking water from reusable bottles.
That's what I do. But what am I supposed to do with this?
Throw it in the recycle bin, buy a reusable bottle or thermos. It's also important to stay informed, communicate with your peers, follow legislation and bills, exercise your right to vote, and of course, spread and obtain information whenever possible.
Yes, thank you for that information.
Welcome.
It seems making a difference is easier than I thought.
Just a matter of putting plans into action. Speaking of which, I got some plans of my own. Catch you next time.
See you, Sophie.
Ah, yeah.
This has been a hit at the office. Now everyone has got one. About legislation, I did some research after chatting with Sophie. And it gave me hope. Countries around the world have come together and developed some striking new policies to stop the deterioration of our climate. This includes legislation on climate change mitigation, like the Paris Agreement, a treaty between 190 countries which lays a global framework to limit global temperature to 2 Celsius degrees or 1.5 Celsius degrees if possible. The latest IPCC report shows the target is very ambitious and will be difficult to achieve without drastic efforts. Like the European Green Deal that still targets to contribute to climate neutrality by 2050 and to reduce greenhouse gases by over 55% by 2030. All in all, just remember, rapid climate change is largely due to anthropogenic or human factors. Greenhouse gas emissions are the major contributor to climate change. The energy supply sector is the most emissive. Even today, climate change has a damaging effect on energy consumption and the power grid. There are many global policies and community efforts to fight against climate change. So get involved and make less of an impact where you can. Stay informed, cut consumption, think green, and share your knowledge whenever possible. Together, we can make a difference. I'm Frederick from What's What. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Oh, and if you got any tips on how to sustain, share them below in our comment section. See you next time.